And there, you can just see on the end of her left tusk, that's obviously been broken at some point and then rubbed down. Now, we've spoken many, many times about the fact that elephants favor one tusk over another. And in this case, I think it's safe to assume that she favors her left one. And her tusks are completely stained. You can just see the tip of the one is with white, where it's been rubbed. But most of the tusks are covered in plant material. Just going to listen to her crunch that branch. You can see how her lips are moving as well, in tandem with her trunk and the crunching motion of her teeth. Her lips are also very, very flexible and help her to perform the more delicate work of rotating a branch and stripping it at the same time. Using that foot to get right at the roots of this raisin bush. I think it's safe to say it's the end of it. Jesus. That kind of show of strength is absolutely phenomenal. I don't know what kind of pulling force she must have exerted there, but I can only imagine. And that was done purely with that wonderful appendage that is the trunk. And it's phenomenal to think that she can do something like that, pull a raisin bush entirely out of the ground. And you saw how deep and long those roots were as she pulled it up. You can just imagine how firmly anchored it was. She can pull down branches of knobthorns and other trees and marulas, and yet she's capable of that delicate coordination with just the tip of the trunk. They really are mind-blowingly amazing animals. The whole root system is going into her mouth now.